Let's get the latest on the federal election. And the Prime Minister has once again faced voter anger at a pub, this time in Western Sydney. Watch this.
I'll ask one question, ScoMo. Look, across the room, I hope you don't mind, I'm just recording.
No, why is it recording?
Oh, I just want to ask you a question.
Wait, I'm sorry, this is a private event.
Oh, well, sorry about that.
This is a media. Well, I'm hosting some drinks for the media event.
I just want to ask a question.
Sorry, what's going on?
ScoMo, across the river here, across the Nepean River, People lost their houses, and they were burnt. You're a disgrace. You are a disgrace.
The Prime Minister's security detail removed the man from the venue. For the latest on the campaign, we have Chloe Burris travelling with the PM, and in Melbourne, following the opposition leader, is Stella Todorovic. Chloe, we'll start with you. Were you at the event last night where the PM got confronted, and can you tell us what went down?
Good morning. Yes, I was right there, actually. The Prime Minister was hosting a private function at a sports club in Penrith. It was media drinks, actually, which is pretty normal on a campaign for both sides of politics. And I was actually chatting to the Prime Minister at the time, and then this young man turned around and said, "Can I get a selfie?" And straight away, he kind of went, "Oh, you're probably not one of the travelling media pack then." And all of a sudden, it was really fiery, as you heard there. He was saying, across the river, people have lost homes. The PM started to walk away, and then he was shouting, "You are a disgrace, you are a disgrace." And the security guard grabbed him, his beer spilled everywhere as he was escorted out. And very soon after, we saw the video posted to TikTok, and that's how we learned he's a 20-year-old from the Blue Mountains, so, you know, lives nearby, he says, and he is a very active Labor campaigner.
Got to wonder why they keep putting on drinks around angry voters. But as you say, it is a Labor activist. It's the second time, Chloe, that we've seen this happen at a pub. Do you think his team will be cracking down on security from here on in?
Well, I mean, this was a private event anyway, and, you know, the guy apparently knew someone who worked there, even managed to get himself a beer before he approached the Prime Minister. That being said, though, we've been on the campaign for a couple of days now, and every job we've done so far has actually been really stage-managed, you know, very controlled by the media team, where we go and who the PM's talking to. So, really, this was the first interaction I've seen so far on the official campaign with a member of the public, and he was not happy.
No, that's it. Stella, yesterday Anthony Albanese met one of our favourites, Father Bob. He got a bit of a lesson on Star Trek, I believe. Father Bob, he really is. He's one of a kind.
Yeah, he really is one of a kind. He's a Melbourne icon, and he is an icon across Australia as well. He definitely stole the show yesterday afternoon, and it was amazing. He had us all in stitches, and he did give his political blessing to Anthony Albanese and also threw in a few life lessons there, and wouldn't we all be so lucky to get some life lessons from Father Bob?
Yeah, we're going to listen to the start here.
Where no one has gone before, as in Star Trek. Where am I going? We're going where no one else has gone before. And that is into this, the future of this magnificent democracy of ours. But it's not going to sit there like a plum pudding all day. It's got to be worked. Worked as a work of art.
Maybe that's the miracle that ScoMo was praying for. And Stella, Mr Albanese said that he's hoping to shake off the mistake of not knowing the cash and the unemployment rate. How's he doing with that?
Well, look, he's definitely channeling his inner Taylor Swift. We didn't quite know he had it in him, but he has been trying to do that. Whether it'll be successful, we'll see. There are reports this morning that the internal Labor campaign is looking at changing tack after what happened on Monday. So I guess we'll see how the rest of the campaign goes from here. We do have a very long few weeks to go. So whether a change of tactics will help or whether just brushing up on those key figures is the key, we will see, won't we?
Yeah, that's it. Chloe, Nationals MP George Christensen, he's quit the party and now said that he's going to be joining One Nation. Is this a blow to the coalition?
Well, it's certainly a surprise, but anything is possible during a campaign. We do know that Mr. Christensen does have a big popularity and a big fan base, so there is a chance he could be taking votes away from the coalition.
All right, Chloe, and what's the Prime Minister doing today?
Well, I'm about to jump on that bus, actually, and from there I have no idea. We haven't actually left New South Wales yet, and like I said, it's been a long time already on the campaign to just stay in the one state. Obviously shows how important New South Wales is, but I do suspect we will be heading interstate today. Where we're going, we'll have no idea. We'll find out when we land and pull out Google Maps.
Stella, you're following the opposition leader. What's he up to?
Yep. Also pretty light on the details this morning as to what exactly we are doing and where we're going, but we do know that healthcare is going to be another major focus of the day. He has been pushing this for a few days now, and today he will be announcing $135 million over 4 years to create 50 Medicare urgent care clinics across the country. So that's what he's going to be talking about. It is a pretty significant announcement. Let's see if it gets the airtime that it deserves.
All right, for a full wrap of today's campaign, you can catch Stella and Chloe tonight on 10 News First at 5. Thank you so much. We'll let you get to it.